How's it going, guys? Today, we're going to be taking a look at the new Hiya Toys Godzilla 2019 from King of the Monsters. A very anticipated figure indeed. Now, I personally have been waiting for this guy for a very long time because the Monster Arts, Legendary Godzilla, and the NECA, they're really good figures, but just so far, we really haven't had a figure that could quite replicate the just awesomeness of Legendary's Godzilla design. Now we've gone, you know, very close, obviously, Monster Arts and NECA, but I feel like this could quite possibly be one of, one of the best Godzilla figures in existence. Yeah, honestly, really. This is an amazing figure. The box, kind of a 360 there. Give you one more look. It's Godzilla on the back, pretty cool pose. Some stuff I have no clue what it actually means. Bottom of the box, KOTM. Top of the box, same thing. Side KOTM again, which, something I'd like to note, this is very, very reminiscent of the NECA, of NECA's Spitfire design that they gave for that figure's box. And just to kind of show you what I mean, you see it, don't you? See the same kind of gray for the outline of the box, it's the exact same thing for the NECA. Okay, look at that. Four dots right there. Get into frame. And it's the same design in the background for the poster. The poster for Godzilla 2019, which is actually on my backdrop right there. It just kind of fell over. So, yeah, you really see it. Out of the box too. Yeah, it's the same thing. It's literally NECA's box, but sideways, which isn't really a problem, but you just, the similarities are just too similar to not talk about. Obviously, NECA's can open up. I really like that. That looks cool. Good to see the figure inside. This is not a NECA review, I'm just kind of showing you. So, it's just very, very similar to Hiya's box design, and something I'd like to point out. The spines on Godzilla in this photo, it's really high quality here, and then the spines. What's going on here? Yeah. What's going on here? Cool. But, yeah. Similarities. It's just too similar to go unnoticed. So with that out of the way, that pretty much covers it for the box. Let's just jump in. Oh, man. Oh, geez. Here he is. Just wow. Honestly, just wow. The detailing. I just would like to first go off and talk about the spines here. Just jumping into the detailing and paint. I initially, seeing the promotional photos and seeing other reviews of them, I thought that the kind of clayish dirt that they were gonna have in like the crevices of his chest right here was gonna be like really, really noticeable and kind of like ruin the figure a little bit for me, but it really doesn't. It looks great. It looks amazing, honestly. And in person, it just looks so, so much better than, you know, seeing photos of it online, which it looked great online. Looked amazing. But just seeing it in person is just wow. Wow, the detailing on this guy. It's just amazing. I'd like to point out, if it could, like, you know, focus, it probably won't, but on his eye here, you can see that it is fully painted, and it isn't messy at all. Maybe what I could do for you guys is kind of zoom in. Yeah, you see it right there. The detailing on the eye. It's amazing. That looks astonishing. Front view of his face. Same thing on the side of the eye. Focus, focus, please. That looks, yeah, that just looks amazing. And then it even kind of has like the dirt over here on his mouth. It looks kind of muddy, but like from afar that doesn't look too bad, and I think it gives this Godzilla some, you know, some characteristics. Is that a real word? Probably isn't a real word. I am making up things right now. I didn't have the best of sleep. I did a lot of stuff the previous day. So just, yeah, painting and detailing. Definitely just amazing. Truly, this is a really, really good figure. Just, and we haven't even gone to articulation yet, so just see in the back of the spines. You can see there is more of that dirt just in the crevices, and I really appreciate how Hiya took the time to sculpt the detailing in, like, between the spikes right here, because normally, unless you're, like, filming or, you know, the photography or stop motions or whatever, probably wouldn't be filming too much of Godzilla over here. But they took the time to individually sculpt the dorsal fins on both sides, and that is just amazing of Hiya to do. That is awesome. That is too cool. This figure is too cool, honestly. So now, without further ado, probably the most anticipated part of the review, I'm going to be going over the articulation. So first off, see his head, his face, mouth. Open up like that. Nom nom nom. Very fun. And then his tongue can also move up and down, which is very, very cool. They didn't have to do that, but that is awesome. His head can do a, I can imagine a full 360, but I don't want to force it. Look to the side, to the other side. Look up really well, and then not that much down. And then I'm just going to cover over on the neck. I don't know if these are individual joints right here or not. I'm not really sure, but they definitely help move him around a lot. That is just too cool. And now, going down to the arms, kind of the same deal with NECA's. We got a rotation at the base of the arm, and that kind of going further down to his hand. That's a swivel. It's on a hinge, but it can also pretty tight swivel, but it can still move. And his hand can, it's on a, I don't know if it's on a ball joint or not. I think it is, yeah. It's either on the same hinge joint that was used for right here. Correct me if I am wrong. But yeah, that is very cool. Same thing the other arm. And he can swivel here. Pretty tight, though. I can imagine it's a 360, but I really don't want to force it. Side view. Very cool. So you can get him into some cool poses. Just kind of like this. It's pretty cool. Going down to his legs. See, we got kind of just another swivel right here. And he could bend out that far. Not too exciting, but he could definitely like move his legs in a lot, which kind of looks pretty weird, but still can. Very cool. And you have kind of this weird joint here, which allows this part of the leg to really get these crazy movements, and it could kind of kick out pretty far. Unlike the NECA, it actually doesn't have a big gap right here, which is awesome, because that was a really big problem with the NECA figure. Same thing with this side of the leg, and we have a rotation kind of right here. You can kind of see a little bit, not too noticeable, but pretty cool. And then we do have a very limited swivel on his foot. Now moving on to Godzilla's tail, we have a what appears to be I don't know if this is a ball joint or not. It could be either or. It can just swivel. And then same thing with right here, very tight still. And I did take a blow dryer to the figure, and it's tight, but at least it's solid, which is It was cool to see. Another swivel. And another swivel again. And same thing here. And then at the tip of the tail is on a ball joint. Not sure about all the other parts of the figure. Oh, and then right here too. Very nice ball joint. Very nice indeed. So with the articulation, I just demonstrated you can get him to lots of dynamic poses of poses. Of course, it's still pretty limited at the tail. You still get good movement here, but it's nothing like the Monster Arts. Maybe I just need to loosen it up a little bit more, but it still moves great, and it's pretty sturdy. It could hold a decent pose before it starts leaning down, but overall, the tail is good movement, and everything else is just wonderful. So you can make him, I don't know, do whatever the heck you want. Hiya. Articulation for being $60 is what I paid for him, MSRP 50. Very, very good. I think just the detailing makes up for kind of the lack of articulation, but at least it can move a lot more than the NECA's. Still not as much as the Monster Arts, but I'd much rather take movie accuracy than articulation, even though articulation is always awesome. Now on to the size comparison. Here's it compared to some NECA Godzilla figures in my collection. With the Spitfire V2 Godzilla, which is very cool. This is actually my first ever Godzilla figure, believe it or not, so this guy holds a special place in my heart, but I'd much rather choose this guy, because he's awesome, but in terms of King of Monsters, Godzilla, he's just the one you're going to want to go with. And here we have the freakishly tall Godzilla 2003, I believe, from Tokyo SOS. Very cool, and is just about the same height as our Hiya Godzilla here. And just because I felt like it, here's it compared to the 2014 NECA Godzilla, the V3, the one with the really good paint and the actual box that they put effort into, which previously was my main Godzilla that I just have that wasn't, you know, Heat Ray or Spitfire or Thermonuclear. So this guy was the kind of one I had to work with. But now, yeah, I kind of have his replacement. Here's it compared to some Bandai vinyls with the Bandai Creation King Ghidorah from GMK, I believe, even though it doesn't look too similar other than the heads, of course, and the Movie Monster Series Space Godzilla. Here's it compared to some Monster Arts figures with the Monster Arts Gigan 2004 from Final Wars, and also from Final Wars, the Godzilla 2004. Which is my favorite Godzilla design. That's a very controversial opinion, but I stand by it. And finally, here's it compared to his co-stars from GBK, with the Playmates Kong with Battle Axe, and the Monster Arts Mecha Godzilla, which actually I really, really like the scaling here, because this guy compared to the Monster Arts Godzilla, that it doesn't really look that good, because obviously Mechagodzilla is bigger than Godzilla, but he just wasn't that colossal compared to Godzilla. And I feel like that the Hiya Godzilla just really, really goes great with the Monster Arts Mechagodzilla. The scaling is really, really good here. And then, of course, let's put Kong in the back here. He's a little bit small, but at least he's not as small as the Monster Arts Kong. Actually, I don't have that, so I can't really tell you. I'm looking forward to getting the Hiya Kong when it releases. And I heard that a Hiya Mechagodzilla is also coming out too, which I don't really know how that's going to work, because the Hiya figures are bigger, and Mechagodzilla is a little bit bigger, so I don't know if the Hiya Mechagodzilla will be larger than the already pretty big Monster Arts Mechagodzilla, or what's gonna happen. But yeah, the scaling's great, and I think these two will look amazing with each other on the shelf, of course. So overall, final thoughts on the Hiya 2019 Godzilla. I think this is just an amazing figure. I think that it actually does everything that the Monster Arts Legendary Godzilla does, but so much better. And it's just an amazing figure. The articulation for its price is great. The paint and the detailing is just fantastic for the price, and marks all the boxes when it comes to a Godzilla figure. So if you're looking for a Godzilla, a legendary Godzilla to add to your collection, I think Hiya is just 100% the way to go. It gets the articulation down, the paint and detailing is just, again, it's amazing. And it's just so much better than the NECA and Monster Arts combined, honestly. This is truly the beginning of a new era for figures, because Monster Arts has always been on top, but for legendary, for their legendary figures, they just never did all that well compared to their figures for, like, say, Heisei or Millennia or Showa. But just, I think that this figure is 100% worth it, and I'm so glad to finally have them in my collection. So that's gonna wrap up the video, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed, and this is Radical signing out.